You equality hoes is messing it up. You're messing it up. I don't want equality. I just stopped at the store to get some water before my workout, and this man did not hold the door for me, and I'm upset. I'm angry. I want to be treated like a lady at all times. Hold the door for me. Get the door. Can I get it myself? Yes. Do I want to? No. 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 It's your job. Change my oil, baby. Take care of me, daddy. I'm gonna fix the plate. I'm gonna keep the house clean. I'm that woman. Okay? All this equality, we can do this shit. Y'all can have it. I don't want it. Mm-mm. I'm not as strong as though I'm not a goddamn man. Let a man be a man. Okay?
One day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I must confess that that dream that I had that day has at many points turned into a nightmare. Now, I'm not one to lose hope. I keep on hoping. I still have faith in the future. But I've had to analyze many things over the last few years, and I would say over the last few months. I've gone through a lot of soul-searching and agonizing moments, and I've come to see that we have many more difficult days ahead, and some of the old optimism was a little superficial, and now it must be tempered with a solid realism. And I think the realistic fact is that we still have a long, long way to go.
You can't take 9 teenage women and seduce them and give them babies and not tell me you're and then tell me you're moral. You could do it if you admitted you did it and admitted that the babies were yours. I'd shake your hand and call you a man, a good one too. But anytime you seduce teenage girls and make them be charged with adultery, make them hide your crime. Why, you're not even a man, much less a divine man. So, and this is what he did. He took at least 9 that we know about. And I'm not speculating because he told this to me himself.
God has a funny way of showing you lessons. For years I would stare up in the sky with so many questions.
What's up, y'all? So make sure you guys see that last advertisement, Silent Hero Films. Click the link below. Silent Hero Films, man, and support my projects, man. I got 2 projects up there, man. And this is a video that you probably can't show your grandmother, your great-grandmother, if she's still alive, great-grandfather, grandfather, because they have believed for so long that equality is the answer. Standing beside the majority, we're not gonna put a color on it because it's 2023, you know what I mean? But the power of the majority fighting for equality was a solution. As you can see, the black woman who's a comedian, you guys go follow her. I intentionally left her name at the top of her Instagram so you guys can go follow her and watch the video. It's on her stories today for the next 24 hours. Please go follow Chelsea and support. I actually know her. So, and then you saw Malcolm X about the liberals and the Northerners, the Southerners, it's all the same. And Martin Luther King and the March on Washington, which was this past weekend anniversary. And 5 years later, he comes and says, "Let us to a burning building." And it's a fallacy. Equality is a fallacy. Now, when you talk to from marriage, one of the key components is marriage, 75, over 70%. In the black community, because people desired to be equal. Oh, I like him because we have so many similarities together. No, you're not going to be opposite. You're not going to be the same. Men and women can never be the same. Like, we love God, we hate science. Right? No matter what religion you believe in, to my understanding, feel free to correct me if I'm wrong, but let's just stick with the major ones. Major ones, like it's a record label or, you know. Buddha, male. Muhammad, male. Jesus, male. So obviously, if man is good enough to lead your religion, he's good enough to lead your home. And men and women got to go with this, especially women, got to go with the same. And this ain't a color. Talking women in general. The same humility that you have for your male boss is the same humility you need to have for your man in your house. From a political standpoint, they have done a doozy on the minority community, thinking that if you can just live the same, fighting for equality, if I can look like the majority, because it's different, it's evolved. It's not, the majority is not white anymore. It's not. You can literally buy yourself into the majority. You can literally earn your way, work your way into the majority. I am an example of that. I am the, what was the majority in the 60s? Like, well, not the majority, but like the elite status. I've worked myself into the elite status. Y'all don't see it. Y'all say, oh, no. I don't get pulled over by the police. My kids go to a school where tax dollars are great. I don't spend a lot of time in an impoverished neighborhood in terms of family events. It's always around quote unquote elite company, Dre, doctor friends. Every time I watch a fight at my business partner's house, there's easily nine figures of land value that we own collectively. You know, that's over $100 million. I go from mansion to mansion, big house to big house, you know, and I'm using me as the example, because you think that you're fighting for equality, that you got to have this hotep, stay in the hood mindset. No. It's about elevation. It's about growth, separation. See, equality done convince you that snitching keeps the community. No snitching keeps the community safe. Equality got Nipsey Hussle murdered. He wanted to stay in the hood. Equality exterminates the minority. Fighting for equality exterminates the black people. Fighting for equality will exterminate the Latino community and whoever else wants to fight for equality. No, be yourself. On a micro level, be yourself. You one of one. As a collective, stop fighting to be like somebody else. Celebrities, they all look alike, right? Right? Women, y'all all look alike. Everyone getting BBLs. Well, in big cities like LA. I'm about to walk into a gym. There will be a woman in there with either fake breasts, fake lips, or BBL. That's a guarantee. And it's a private gym. See, this is another way how I've worked my way into the elite status. I pay $100 a month to go to this gym. You get what I'm saying? Like, you can literally work hard to put yourself out of this big cesspool. And when you're in this elite status, individuality reigns supreme. Elon Musk. Warren Buffett, Robert Johnson, Michael Jordan, I've just named billionaires who they are nothing alike. As individuals, they're nothing alike in terms of savviness with their money. They may have some similarities, but in terms of individuality and their gifts and their talents, everybody want to be a thug. Everybody want to be a real N-word, the community in which I come from. Fighting for equality has literally ruined, is ruining individuality. And Not having individuality means lack of homes, lack of structure in homes. If both parents are the same, then there should only be one. My business partner always says, D-Mac, Derek, I mention him a lot. He says, when two people are the same, one becomes obsolete. I repeat, when two people become the same, one becomes obsolete. Simple. If I got two people doing the same job, I'm going to fire one or release one. Say, I just need him. Right? Am I right? If this was a basketball team, do you need 2-point guards who can't shoot? No, you need a guard who can shoot, a center who can rebound. You know what I mean? You get what I'm saying? Like, in relationships and fighting for the underserved, you think that you got to fight for equality. No. You ain't fighting for equality. The Constitution in 2023 is more alive than it's ever been. And I know you may not see it from your hood vernacular. I know you may not see it from your Hotep vernacular. I know you may not see it from your white supremacy vernacular or your pro whatever. The Constitution in 2023 is alive and well. I am a living testimony of that. Fred, no, I don't experience racism. Systemic racism? You know, I don't know. Because when I try and get these 1.9% loans, I get them. Because I did the work. My credit score is yay high. You get what I'm saying? Like, when I refi and they say we can get it as low as possible, my earned income and my credit score allows me to get that low interest rate. So when people say, oh, I don't really have that, like, because I've worked hard on the things I needed to work on, my credit score, my earned income, my family, my kids have an obligation, an instrument, a language, and a sport. Simple. They got to have three in the Hawthorne household. And I know I'm scattered all over the place, but the point I want to make is, black woman, since a black woman said it, y'all got to stop fighting for equality. You can't be a man. It's impossible. You've been hoodwinked and bamboozled. The three most powerful men, the four most powerful men, the five most powerful men that I could think of off the top of my head, W.E.B. Du Bois, Frederick Douglass, up from slavery. Tuskegee. How am I drawing a blank on? Anyways, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King. It'll come back to me. I see him right now. Anyways, I'm looking dead at his face, but I can't think. Those five are probably, you may throw in Marcus Garvey if you a Garveyite or a Hotep, you know. Those six men. I'm stuck on this. And why do I draw blanks in the middle of videos sometimes? But anyway, put his name in the comment section, dog. You know what I mean? I just read his book with Lincoln, dog. God, dog it. Anyways, they will tell you. The Democratic Party is a doozy. Frederick Douglass was a Republican. In 1967, Martin Luther King was anti-Democrat. As you guys can see, Malcolm X has always been that way. I should say always been that way, but at least the last 12 years of his life. W.E.B. Du Bois was his arch enemy, the guy I'm drawing a blank on. I don't know why I'm drawing. Do for self, man. What is that? God, dog it. Anyways, man. Anyways, pick up your boots. That was one of his famous quotes from the book. W.E.B. Du Bois left America and never came back. He's buried in Africa. Malcolm X went to visit his wife in the 60s. 64. And we sitting here believing that we gotta be what? The nerve of us fighting for equality. So black woman, listen to this woman. If you want to have equality, if you really, really fighting for equality, yes, you got to simplistic things. Yes, you got to open up your door. Yes, you got to change your oil. Yes, you got to pay for dates. That's just on the first floor. But when you start to thinking, how you going to have a child? How you going to raise a family thinking you want to be like a man? Now let's take it to religion. How you going to have true faith in your religion, whichever one you believe in, without trusting a man to lead you? Because in these major religions, a man, I don't care what color he is, a man leads you. Your boss. He leads you. So anyways, man, y'all have a great day, man. Yeah, man. Y'all have a great day, man. Barbershop conversations, man. This conversation, dessert needs to be had. Let's be clear. I'm not advocating that you be a Republican. I'm advocating that you not be a Democrat. I'm advocating that you don't subscribe to this liberal doctrine. I'm advocating that you don't put political clout over your spiritual faith. I'm asking that you not put political clout over science. Simple science, man, female. If you take the average man, the average woman at 22, there's a distinct difference. 23, 24, there's a distinct difference between male and female. That's who we are. But we fall into this comfortability. We eat too much. We don't work out. Life gets in the way. Capitalism gets in the way. Family gets in the way. So we start to bleed in together. We get fat together. We, you know what I mean? We start to look alike because we get the same habits. But when you look at the average 23, 24, 25-year-old male and female, that's who we are. We're distinctly different. Be that. Black woman. Y'all better listen to Chelsea. Y'all have a great day. I'm gone.